All right, one other question I'm actually kind of surprised you didn't ask me is what's this rollout nonsense?
Oh, I
Really?
recognize that from reading about TD Gammon.
How is it
So
the
the
same?
word actually comes from an understanding of how people figure out which backgammon boards are better or worse. They actually will, the rolling here is the rolling of the backgammon dice.
That's not at all what I was thinking.
Oh, so what were you thinking?
Well, I was just thinking that we have some rollout policy. Which tells us what to do when we're here. And I said, well, let's just act randomly. But I don't know why that's the right thing to do. I mean, if I end up here and I've like got to do something, we're trying to get an estimate of this state and taking this particular action and ending up in this state. Why is that good or bad? And the way you're going to do it is I'm going to say, well, I know how good it is to be here by behaving randomly from that point on. I mean, that'll give you probably an underestimate of the true value. But it would be nice if you could do something that perhaps made a little more sense. So people who've done work on MCTS have often put some effort into, well, lots of things, being clever about this expansion, keeping the right set of statistics, kind of, shoving their exploration in very smart ways. But other people have spent a little bit of effort trying to figure out, can I come up with a better policy besides behaving randomly, that will help me to have a better estimate of this particular Q value? And we could talk about it. I'm going to just quickly talk about one by mentioning something that we have already talked about so far in this lesson. Do you remember the commands you came up with for Pac-Man?
Oh, it was like eat, 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 avoid.
Right. So
It was
there were
like
three.
eat little dots, eat big dots, eat ghosts, avoid.
Right. So I'm going to point out that of those four, which I'll just call eat, 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 and avoid, which one of those is different?
So I don't know, the first one
Eat.
where you're eating big dots, yeah, or small
Yeah.
dots. No,
Okay, well,
I guess you want me to say avoid
I
because
do
it's
want you to
the
say
word
avoid.
that's different in the list.
Avoid is different, but it's actually different in a different way. Here we said, eat a little dot, eat a big dot, eat a ghost, and avoid ghosts. Remember when I said before that, temporal extraction becomes goal abstraction? I'm going to claim that each of these does have a goal. One is to eat little dots, one is to eat big dots, and one is to eat little goblins. But that when you execute the eat small dot, it actually terminates. At some point, you eat a small dot, and now you can move on to the next thing. At some point, you eat a large dot, and now you can move on to the next thing. At some point, you eat a goblin, and then you can move on to the next thing. But avoiding goblins, avoiding ghosts, that isn't really something that ends. You're supposed to be avoiding ghosts all the time.
I see. Well, I guess it's sort of the negation. I do understand how that's different now. So, and eating the ghost ends when you succeed. Avoiding, I want to say, ends when you fail, right?
Right.
Like I'm avoiding the ghost. Oh, I wasn't able to avoid the ghost.
Right. So, in fact, these things have sort of goals. They have success conditions. They end when you succeed. Avoid is a little different. It sort of ends only when you fail. You can never succeed at avoiding ghosts. You can only fail at it in some sense.
Yeah,
Whereas
okay, I
here,
agree with that.
there's a sort of finite time in which you achieve your goal, and that's success. So it turns out that when you ask people to come up with these kinds of things, these kinds of options, they actually come up with things that look like this, lots of goals with lots of success metrics, but they also come up with things where you can sort of only fail. We actually have a word for that, and they're called constraints.